To giving you a quick short intro quickly. Today we are going to cover one of the most important aspects of astrology, that is avasthas. Okay, most important and most misunderstood, the avasthas of the planets. Okay, the avasthas of the planets are mentioned in many texts. Though in parampara, the tradition of astrology, we follow a particular order. And some of the text in the starting doesn't mention about avasthas. But later on, when the text go more deeper into it, there are avasthas that are mentioned. For this year, there is a particular course coming, Parashar Sutras. And through that course, what I wish to achieve is the authentic Parashar. So BPHS is there. And you have seen me saying that BPHS is not a very authentic text. But Parashar is a great sage. The discrepancies that have crept into BPHS is because of we people. The sage was extremely right when he told BPHS to Maitreya, when he told the knowledge to Maitreya. But when it was written, interpreted, translated, it became a problem. Right? So my target basically, for now and for the coming months and in the course, is to give you a glimpse of taste of the real Parashar. Okay. And in that particular, in that, to achieve that, basically, today we will see the avasthas. Okay. So first of all, the major misconception that is there regarding the avastha is the Baladi avastha. Right, so Parashar specifically mentions there is a chapter on avastha in BPHS where Parashara specifically mentions that there are six avasthas. Avastha means a condition or a stage. So there are six avasthas of a planet, that is infant state, bal avastha, youthful state, kumar avastha, adolescent state, that is yuva avastha, old state, that is Amrit Avastha, and dead state, that is Mrit Avastha. Advanced state, that is Vriddha Avastha, and the last stage is Mrit Avastha. Right? And this is for the odd signs, basically. For even signs, this order is reversed. So basically, there are five Avasthas that we have learned. Okay? Bal Avastha, Kumar Avastha, Yuva Avastha, Vriddha Avastha, Mrit Avastha. Okay, the six avasthas are there. A Rashi is of 30 degrees. And that 30 degree is divided into six portions. So when you divide 30 degree into six portion, what is the answer? Sorry, five portion. These are the five. Na? Bal Avastha, Kumar Avastha, Yuva Avastha, Vriddha Avastha, Mrit Avastha. Five portions. These are the five portions. One Rashi is 30 degree. When you divide a Rashi of 30 degree into five portions, 6 degree per portion. So 0 to 6 degree planet is in Bal Avastha. 6 degree to 12 degree planet is in Kumar Avastha. 12 degree to 18 degree planet is in Yuva Avastha. 18 degree to 24 degree planet is in Vriddha Avastha. And 24 degree to 30 degree planet is in Mrit Avastha. And this order is for the male sign or odd sign, that are Aries, Gemini, Leo, Libra, Sagittarius, and Aquarius. For the female sign, the order is reversed. So 0 to 6 degrees Mrit Avastha, death state. 6 to 12 degrees Vriddha Avastha, old state. 12 to 18 degrees is common between them, that is Yuva Avastha. 18 to 24 degrees Kumar Avastha, that means young, and 24 to 30 degrees Bal Avastha, that means a child. This is for the female signs or the even signs, that are Taurus, Cancer, Virgo, Scorpio, Capricorn, and Pisces. Many people use these avasthas. Very often I see a comment, you know, sir, my sur, my son is in Bal Avastha, will it not give me result, etc., etc. These avasthas are highly erroneous. Not useful at all. Why? Because it contradicts the Parashara's dictum itself. It is in contradiction with complete astrology. It kills the soul of astrology, this particular avastha. Why? So basically, in all of these avasthas, the Yuva avastha, planet from 12 degree to 18 degree, only this planet is good, gives full result. The planet in Bala avastha cannot give result like a child. Planet in Kumara avastha can give some result. Planet in Yuva avastha gives complete result. Planet in Vriddha avastha, that is an old person, is very feeble like an old person. And planet in Mirdha avastha, it is told that the result of the planet have died, evaporated. Going to the text of Parashara itself, Parashara mentions the planet with highest degrees is Atmakara. Though this is not the right interpretation, right? Planet with highest degrees is not the Atmakara. Planet with highest minutes is the Atmakara. That is my own research. I have produced many videos and articles on it also. And as I am saying, it is my research. Right? So, like, you know, no one else. And then there are other things as well. That is the real purport of Jaimini when he wanted to describe about Charakaragas. And that was to find the Charakaragas using minutes and not using degrees. But there are many people who put the chapters on Jaimini in Brihat Parashar while reading Jaimini or practicing Jain. And that is one of the biggest problems. Why? That we will explain sometime later. I will explain sometime later. But this basic point, because Jaimini have mentioned planet with highest minute as Atmakarak very clearly. But if you go to Parashara's text, he have mentioned planet with highest degrees as the Atmakarak. And Atmakarak is the king of the horoscope. Atmakarak is the most powerful planet in the horoscope. If you go and find the strength according to Jaimini astrology, Atmakarak should be the most powerful planet. Now, keeping in mind this Bala avastha, Kumara avastha, Yuva avastha, Vriddha avastha, and Mrita avastha, the Atmakarak will either be Bala or Mrita, leading to no result. The highest degree planet, and most probably the Amatyakarak also, will be either Bala or Mrita, leading to no result. Are you getting my point? Right. So, Parashara specifically mentions, as you can see the shloka, I have clipped it. Atha aham samprakshami grihana atmadikarakan. Now I am telling you planets as they become atmakarak, etc. Saptaravyadi shanyantan out of saptaravya, seven ravyadi shanyatan from sun to Saturn. Rahavantan, leaving Rahu aside. Rahavantan or with Rahu, Vahastu Sankhyakan, these eight planets. Ansay Samo Graho Do Ched Rahavanta Chittiyet Tada, if two planets, he have specifically mentioned this particular word, if you can see it here, Amshay. Samo is means equal. Ansay Samay Graho Do Ched Rahavan Chintiyet Tada, if two planets have same degrees, then think of Rahu as being the Atmakarak. Otherwise, Saptav Karakan Evam Kev Dishto Prajakshate. So Jaimini have mentioned the word minute. Atmakaraka kaladi birna boga sapt ashtanamava is what Jaimini mentions, which doesn't contradict any of the principle. But sadly, people are, I will see, being in love with Parashara is not a problem. Being in blind love with anyone is the problem. So people basically are in so much in blind love with Parashara that they don't see the Parashar himself. Parashar have written Amsha that degrees are to be used to find the Atmakara. And if you follow this particular thing, then Parashar contradicts Parashar. Because according to Parashar, planet with highest degree will become the Atmakara. Okay. According to Parashar, planet with highest degree will become the Atmakara, and that same planet, because he have the highest degree, will be either in the Mrita avastha or will be in the balavastha. Amatkarak also probably will be in the mritavastha or in the balavastha. Dharagarak also will be in mritavastha or balavastha. And jatigarak also will be in mritavastha and balavastha. So out of the 7 charakarakas, 4 charakarakas will be yielding no result at all, according to Vaj. So why he is mentioning? So the basic point is the BEPHS, wherever it mentions Jaimini, that have to be left. Jaimini astrology should be learned from Jaimini, not from Parashar. Okay? This is the basic point. My main topic that we were discussing was the Balyadi Avastha. This Balyadi Avastha have one more issue. Look at the shloka first. Kramad in the order. Bala, child. Kumaro, young. At Yuva. Sorry, Kumaro, adolescent. At Yuva, young. Vridha, old. Tatha mrtah, dead. Sadansa samay, 6 degrees each. Keta, planet, samay, geyo, viparyata. Reverse in the odd signs. Sorry, reverse in the even signs. This is the basic concept, right? So what Parashara is saying is planet in 0 to 6 degree in a male sign will be in Balavastha. Female sign, Mritavastha. And this you have to note it down. Planet between 6 to 12 degrees in a male sign is Kumaravastha. Female sign is Mritavastha. Planet 12 to 18 degree in both the signs will be in Yuvavastha. Planet between 18 to 24 degree in male sign is Vridha Avastha. Female sign is Kumara Avastha. And 24 to 30 degree planet in a male sign is Mrita Avastha and a female sign is a Bala Avastha. And Parashar says that planet in the Bala Avastha and Mrita Avastha doesn't produce any result at all. Planet in Kumara Avastha and Vridha Avastha only produce 50% of feeble results. And planet in Yuva Avastha only can give the result. Why we are not using it? First of all, because of the contradiction I have already told you. Second point I will also give you. According to the canons of astrology, you know there is something known as Shadbal, the sixfold strength of a planet. Parashara also deals about it. The Shadbal is another topic. Let's not talk much about it. But there is one strength in this Shadbal that talks about the strength of planet. It is in Jatak Parijat, it is in Saravali, it is in Faladipika. And what does it say? It says that male planets are powerful in the starting of sign. So male planets, Sun, Jupiter and Mars are powerful in the starting of the sign. Yonuj planet are powerful at the middle of the sign. Yonuj planet, Mercury, Saturn are powerful at the middle of the sign. And female planets are powerful at the end of the sign. Venus and Moon are powerful at the end of the sign. Now there are these three divisions. So basically, Sun, Jupiter and Mars will be powerful in 0 to 10 degrees of Rashi. Parashara also gives the shloka, and according to Parashara himself, at one place, Sun, Jupiter and Mars with one rule, from 0 to 10 degrees, they will be extremely powerful, according to Parashara in a chapter. And in another chapter, the Sun, the Jupiter and the Mars in the same 0 to 10 degrees will be in either in the Balavastha or in the Mritavastha, leading to no result. Are you getting my point? It is okay with Mercury and Saturn, right? Mercury and Saturn are powerful in the middle of the sign. That means Mercury and Saturn is powerful from 10 degree to 20 degree of the Rashi. It will certainly go into the Yuva Avastha. That is very good. Coming to the female planets, the shloka says that the female planets, Venus and Moon, are powerful in the last part of sign. which mean Venus and Moon are powerful from 20 degree to 30 degree of a sign. And according to this Parashar Shloka itself, Venus and Moon will be either in the Mritavastha or in the Balavastha, leading to another result. So once again, it leads to a level of contradiction. So all and all, in and out, the basic thing is Balavastha, Kumaravastha, Yuvavastha, Vriddhavastha, Mritavastha, these avasthas of planets should not be used. Because if you use them, then Parashar is contradicting Parashar. Sun maximum exaltation degree 10. He will be in Kumaravastha, leading to feeble result. Jupiter maximum exaltation degree 5. He will be in Balavastha, leading to no result. Or sorry, it is a female sign. He will be in Mritavastha, leading to no result. Venus maximum exaltation degree 27 in Pisces will be in Balavastha, leading to no result. Mars maximum exaltation degree 28 degree Capricorn, female sign, it will be in Balavastha, leading to no result. So even if you look at the exaltation of the planets, basically according to Parashar, exalted Sun, exalted Jupiter, exalted Venus and exalted Mars leads to no result. Because Sun remains in Balavastha and all other planets, Sun remains in Balavastha, Jupiter remains in Mritavastha. And Jupiter, and Mars and Venus remains in Balavastha. They are leading to no result. So now you are intelligent people. Now I have already told you how it works, right? So the Baladi Avastha of Parashar, you cannot use. Now basically, if you cannot use, then why Parashar have mentioned it? Is there a problem? Do we understand it in the correct way? Let's do this using a few examples. Okay. You won't mind if I take some examples, right? Oh, you certainly will not. I am very sure. Okay. So let's take an example. This is the horoscope of Indira Gandhi. You can see the horoscope. I'm pretty sure you can. This is the horoscope of Indira Gandhi. She, Indira Gandhi, got childbirth on 20th August 1944. I'm using a standard Vimshottari Dasha calculated from Moon. 20th August 1944, Indira Gandhi got a child. It was Rahu Dasha, Saturn Antra Dasha, Mars Pratantra Dasha happened. Let's go to the chart of Indira Gandhi. Saturn, Rahu is in which avastha? Rahu is in a female sign, second avastha. That will be in Yuva avastha. Rahu is in Yuva avastha. Saturn is 21 degree. 21 degree will be which avastha?
Sir, I guess Rahu will be in male. Rahu is in male, sir. Male sign.
Rahu is in a male sign. Right. So which avastha Rahu will be? Rahu is in 8 degree. Yeah, I have told you the right avastha. Rahu will be in Kumara avastha. Right?
Kumara.
राहु विल बी इन कुमार अवस्था. should I write it to you? People are difficult to find, you people find difficult remembering it. So I have written it here.
Saturn is in old avastha.
I will write it once again. Mrit Buddha Yuva Kumara and Bala. Let me take it to a new slide so that it doesn't create your problem. These are the avasthas of the planets. Okay, this is for the male sign and this is for the female sign. Rahu Dasha, Saturn Antar Dasha is when Indira Gandhi gets a child. Rahu is in a male sign, 8 degree, goes to Kumar Avastha. I should make it more clear to you. So Rahu is in between 6 degree to 12 degree in a male sign, it goes to Kumar Avastha. And Saturn is in Cancer, a female sign, in 21 degree. That again goes to Kumar Avastha. So Bala means a child. I have to write it. Bala is a child. Kumara is young. Yuva is full grown male or female, whatever you take it. Vriddha is old and Mrita is died. So if you see, both of these planets are in Yuva Avastha, young age. Yuva Avastha indicates a lot of virility and indicates things which you are supposed to have in your young age. The reproductive glands are maximum active at this point of time in the Yuva Avastha in the young age. It gives results such as marriage, childbirth, having the zeal, passion, power, fire, aggression, etc. You know, the things that is synonymous to a young person. Right? So what I am telling you, the research that I am putting in front of you is that rather than, see, Parashar also writes a shloka where he himself says that planet in Bala Avastha is not able to give the result. Planet in Kumara Avastha and Vritta Avastha will only give feeble result. Planet in Vritta Avastha doesn't give the result. Parashar himself writes the shloka. But according to my experience and in the view to correct the adulterated text of Parashar, what I am proposing to you people is we have to ascribe the nature of these planets, the nature of these avasthas to the planets, and see that, check that in dasha antar dasha for the type of result the planet will be producing. Do you get my point? Let's see a few more examples. I will stick to the chart of Indira Gandhi. Yeah. I will stick to the chart of Indira Gandhi. She got married in 1942. 1942 is Rahu Disha. Right? Rahu is in Yuvavastha. Right, giving the, sorry, Rahu is in Kumaravastha. Extremely sorry. Rahu is in Kumaravastha. Giving the result which are supposed to come in the adults. As I told you, marriage, sexuality, child. I told you before, no, marriage. Marriage, sexuality, birth of child, you know, courage. These things that young people have. You know, the energy, the fire to break the world, change the world. And this is what is happening with the Rahu Disha. Okay? Let's go deeper into it. The Lagna Lord Moon is in 3 degree Capricorn. That will be, Capricorn is a female sign, that will be Amritavastha. So certainly Indira Gandhi was not died, basically. She was alive. Right? So literally you cannot take it. Dashantra, Dasha, you are supposed to take it. She gets another child on 14th December 1946. 14th December 1946. Rahu Dasha, Mercury Yantra Dasha, Mars Pratantra Dasha is when it is happening. Right? I have taken the Dasha Antra Dasha, right? About Rahu, you already know. Rahu is in the Yuvavastha, young adolescent. It gives marriage. It gives both the children also. Let's look at Mercury. Mercury is in 12 degrees, 30 minutes in a female sign. You go to the list. Yeah. Mercury is in 12 degree 30 minutes in Scorpio, a female sign. Where it will come? 12 degree to 18 degree, it will come in Yuva again. Young. Once again, the result of Yuva and Kumar is almost similar. The result of Yuva and Kumar is almost similar. So she gets her another child in this Yuva Avastha also. Yuva and Kumar is similar. Both of them means young. Yuva is just a young child and Kumar is a young man. That's all. Right? So Yuva and Kumar both have the same type of result. These are the two good conditions basically. Right? Bala, Vriddha have the same result. Mrita is bad. This point is extremely clear. Sorry, you keep your question. We'll take it in the end, okay? Good. Another thing is she died on 31st October 1984. This was Saturn Dasha, Mars Antra Dasha, Ketu Pratintra Dasha. It was Saturn, Mars, Ketu. Saturn, 21 degree female sign, is in Kumaravastha. Right? Though she was old, not young. Right? It was Mars Antra Dasha and Ketu Pratyantra Dasha. Mars is in a male sign, 15 degrees. It once again goes to the Yuvavastha. And Ketu, that is in 8 degree of Gemini, a male sign, once again go to the Kumaravastha. So basically, the two things that I am proposing here is, first of all, according to these avasthas, planet give their result. One. Right? Another thing is, because Mrit means dead, the Dasha, Antar Dasha of a Mrit planet basically gives no result. The Dasha and Antar Dasha of a Bal, child, and Vridh, old person, give very few results, weak result. The Dashantra Dasha of Kumar and Yuva planet gives great results. The maximum developments in life happens in the Yuva Avastha and Kumar Avastha, right? The young age. So first of all, I use it to see which Dasha is having how much events. And the event happening in that Dashantra Dasha is of what stature? Point one. Getting my point? This is point one, and point two is results happen according to the nature also. For an example, the child avastha, the bal avastha, the child is very experimentative, right? So the planet in bal avastha in his dasha gives lots of activity. Point one. Child is generally diseased free. Bal avastha planet gives freedom from disease. Right? Child never sit settled at a place. They keep on roaming. The planet in bal avastha give you foreign travels. Loss of settlement, lack of settlement, life, etc. All the things that children do. Getting my mind? And there are many more things that children do. You think over it. And you will know. The planet in Kumar Avastha and Yuva Avastha do the things that we do in our young age, get married, produce children, professional status, fame, income, gain of income, rise of income, and things related to that. Planets in Vriddha Avastha gives you leisure time, a lot of free time. And what else you do in childhood? It is the time when you have your parent, when you have your children and grandchildren. This is the time when you actually finish your duties, finish everything in life, go towards the settlement. And planet in Mrita Avastha doesn't give death, but there is a loss of lots of inactivity. There are diseases, troubles, etc. So what I am proposing you according to my research is that these avasthas have to be understood as the planet in these avastha is behaving like a person of this age group. And the planet in his Dashantra Dasha and in transit will give result according to the age group. So any planet when it is in 0 degree to 6 degree of a male sign or 24 degree to 30 degree of a female sign in transit also, that is a Bal Avastha. And suppose it is your 10th lord that is right now in transit is going through Bal Avastha. Like children, you will do many mistakes in your professional life right now and you have to be careful about it. Right, you get married only when your seventh lord is transiting through Yuva Avastha or Kumar Avastha. That is only when your seventh lord is between 6 degree to 18 degree in a male sign or 12 degree to 24 degree in a female sign, your seventh lord in transit. When he is in these degrees, only in that condition you get married. So basically what I am doing is I am contradicting Parashar. Because Parashar is contradicting Parashar. You know, there was a Hindi movie, Karthik calling Karthik. Isn't it? Parashar contradicting Parashar. That is happening. So I am doing the same thing. And this is what I always do. And you people know, you people are students, you know that. So we don't go by what is written in the text. We go by what, see, we are classical astrologers. We have learned astrology in the traditional way. But it is not copy-paste class. So I have experimented the thing and this is my research, which I have produced in front of you. Talked about one avastha, one type of avastha basically. I will first go to the few important ignored avastha. Few ignored but important avasthas is what I am going to show you. This is another, you see the shloka? स्वभोच्यो समसुहृदभियो शत्रु नीचियो शत्रु नीचियो जागृत स्वप्न सुप्ताख्या अवस्था नाम दृक्फला स्व स्वभो उच्चयो प्लैनेट व्हेन इन एक्सॉल्टेशन और इन हिज ओन साइन समसुहृद भयो प्लैनेट व्हेन ही इज एक्सॉल्टेड और ही इज इन हिज ओन राशि प्लैनेट इज जागृत अवेक When the planet is in a friendly sign or neutral sign, he is in swapna, dreaming state. And when planet is in an inimical rashi or in debilitation, he is in shushupti, that is sleep. And the result is according to the name. I will tell you a very important uses of this. Jagrat avastha planet. Planet in own sign. So I will first tell you about the dreaming state. Okay. I will explain it to you using an example. So once what happened, a person came to me. And he was like, sir, I will open a business. I will earn this money, that money. I have a very good business plan, etc., etc. It is some 5-6 years ago from today. You want to be a partner? I looked at his horoscope. The planet was in a normal Rashi, friendly sign or neither exalted, debilitated, nor own sign or inimical sign. Normal. Normal sign. This is a dreaming state. So the only thing I told you, no, no, I only do Jyotish. I don't want to do partnership, point one. And point two is, you rethink over your plan. I think it is not very much workable. He was very sure about, no, no, sir, this plan is very workable. So I asked him a few questions. And then he realized that you are right, sir, it is not workable. See, this does happen. This does happen with everyone. You know, sometimes we're related. And we imagine a lot of things. That imagination may or may not come true. So basically, this is a self-check. Self-check for you and self-check for everyone. You know, that's why in earlier times, it was essential for everyone to learn astrology. It was forced. Like today, we are forced to learn English, you know. It was forced in earlier times to learn astrology for this particular reason. So if there is a planet in his own Rashi or exaltation sign, whatever ideas, thoughts, etc. are coming to your mind right now, you know, that is a very sensible idea. That idea is very true. You can achieve it. You can succeed into it. If the planet is in a normal sign, a friendly sign or a neutral sign, then at this time, whatever you are thinking, you can achieve that, but some hard work is needed. It is a dream. You can make that dream true, but lots of hard work needed. And if the planet is in inimical sign or debilitated, he is in sleeping mode. You also see dreams in sleep only. But there's a differentiation between dreaming and sleeping. Here, sleeping should be taken as ignorance. So the thoughts and ideas coming to you, when you are going through the dasha antra dasha of a planet who is either debilitated or in an inimical sign, you are basically ignorant, sleeping. That result may not come true. The ideas, yeah, Ajinkya, that is also very important for quick prashna. You're very right. Like quickly, if someone asks you, sir, I want to do this, will I succeed? You check how the Lagna Lord is situated. If the Lagna Lord is sleeping, he will never be able to. If the Lagna Lord is dreaming, then his ideas are very true. He need to work very much. And if the Lagna Lord is Jagrat, awake, then the result is just there. Are you getting my point? This is a self check. And that's why you should learn astrology. The Dasha Antar Dasha Lord, whichever state it is and what you are planning. Right? When you have to be practical, when the planet is sleeping, whatever you are thinking, you have to be practical in it. You are sleeping. The planet is sleeping. Getting my point? When the planet is dreaming, your idea can succeed. A lot of hard work is needed. And when it is the Dasha Antar Dasha of a planet who is in owner Rashi or exalted, then you will surely succeed. So whenever a thought comes to your mind, you can do two things. First of all, you can quickly cast a Prashna chart. Prashna chart is horoscope for that moment. And this is very essential. You know what? I have found this. If you really want to use astrology to your favor, whenever a new idea comes to your mind, check the positions of the planet at that moment itself. Cast a Prashna chart. And that should be telling you whether you should proceed or not. And if you ignore this, then even after learning astrology, you are not using it. Use it to your advantage. That's why you're learning it at the first place, right? So that is the first thing. Whenever an idea comes to your mind, make a Prashna. Check the condition of the planet in Lagna. If there is no planet in Lagna, check the condition of the Lagna Lord. Whether he is awake, sleeping or dreaming. There is one more thing that I do. So if you do Dasha Antar Dasha, you know that there is something known as Prana Dasha. Right? If you quickly go to Jagannath Hora, for an example, suppose I have to take a student from the class. Suppose I take Prajwal. What Prajwal is thinking right now? What is the date today? 13th, January 12th. Okay. So the last what you get is PAD. This, you know, Deha Antar Dasha and PAD, Prana Dasha, etc. And this is one day divided into many portions. And this is the same day divided into many portions, right? This Antar Dasha is long. After that, Pratyantar Dasha is even smaller. Sukshma Dasha changes twice a day. Right? Deha, Prana Dasha is even more feeble, and Deha Antar Dasha and the Prana Dasha is the most feeble. So suppose today Prajwal gets an idea, any idea he gets today. Today is the 12th of January. So right now it is 20:59. Right? From 2020 to 015, it is Rahu Pratyantar Dasha going on. So let's not take Rahu. I have to explain more rules for it, so I will not do it. Let's take Mars. Suppose he got an idea in his mind from 6:48 in the evening to 8:20 in the night. He got some idea. Should he work on that idea? So I look at the Mars. Mars is neither exalted nor debilitated, nor in own Rashi. Is Mars in an inimical Rashi? No, Mars is not into an inimical Rashi. Mars is into a neutral sign. But if you look at the Navamsha, I will come to Navamsha. There is a specific technique for Navamsha also. We'll come to it. Okay. Mars is in a neutral sign. So basically, he is dreaming. This doesn't mean he cannot get the result that he is thinking. Just more hard work needed. So he have to rethink over it. And when to rethink? When should Prajwal rethink? I look at a good planet in his horoscope. I find Sun as a very good planet. Because Sun is in own Rashi. Sun is basically in Jagrat Avastha. He should write down the idea and will think again in the Prana Antar Dasha of Sun. So on 17th of January, from 8 in the morning, he should go deeper into it. Sun, we want. So on 17th of January from 8:10 in the morning to 8:40 in the morning, he should be rethinking over his idea. Right? And whatever new ideas he will get at that point of time is what he should implement. Right now, because the planet is in Swapnavastha, he should drop the idea. We'll find when the Pranadasha, Deha, Antardasha of a planet in Jagratavastha is coming, and at that point of time, he should rethink over it. Right? That is a difficult way. Only good astrologers can do it. You people make a prashna. And that prashna will tell you what actually is going on. And as an astrologer, when someone thinks of something, so suppose you are in an affair with a lady and you want to get married to it. You want to get married to that lady. You know, we generally face such questions. Affair with this lady, want to get married to this lady. Can you get married? I will ask, have you asked the lady, is she ready? The client will tell me, sir, I am planning. So I will check the dasha antardasha. If the planet is in Swapnavastha, etc., I know that the lady will tell you first get settled, then we will think. If the planet is in Mrutavastha, sorry, if the planet is in sleep, then the lady will say no. And if the planet is in Jagratavastha, the lady will say yes. You have given an interview and you are expecting a result. So I will ask, what do you think? He says, sir, I think I will get the job. If it is in the dreaming state, I will say, send them a few more mails or try to contact them because something extra is needed. If the planet is sleeping, no job. And if the planet is in Jagratavastha, if the planet is awake, then you are getting it. Are you getting my point? I can use it in Prashna or I can use the Pratyantradasha, Pranadasha set to do it, to achieve it. Okay. Also one more thing. If any house lord is in a dreaming state, you need to put some effort into that house. If the house lord is in awake, all the wishes and desires related to that house will come to pass. And if the house lord is sleeping, then the good results related to that house is very feeble. To get the result related to that house, a lot of hard work is needed. Do you got my point? Am I very clear? Am I clear? Not clear. This same thing is applicable in Navamsha also. The planet in exalted or un navamsha is awake. Planet in debilitation or inimical navamsha is sleeping. And planet in neutral navamsha is dreaming. You know, in the Prajwal's chart, if you remember, why I said him to think over the topic again. Because if you look at the chart, Mars, the lord of the Deha Antardasha, is in Un Navamsha. That is awake. So it is dreaming awake situation. So he can think again and can get a better idea. If it was dreaming, he's really dreaming. If it is dreaming, sleeping, not much chance. You're getting my point? So you have to have a synchronization of D1 and D9. Looking at D1, the Mars is dreaming. Looking at D9, Mars is in Un Navamsha, he is awake. So dreaming plus awake, it is 70% good. Right? That's why I told him this. that rethink over, because Navamsha have a better prospect. You should rethink. Okay. Always remember one point. The results told in D1 can be 70% modified by the Navamsha. 70% modified by the Navamsha. 75-80% you can also take. The result of D1 can be 80% modified by the Navamsha. 80% is a huge number. Navamsha and Rashi have the equal weightage. Other divisional charts only have 50%. And in that also D16, D10 and D60 have 25% weightage only as per the classics. Now you say, sir, Parashar said, see everything from D60. I told you what Parashar is starting of the class itself, right? I don't think I have to say it again and again. Now, Parashar haven't said, your version of PPHS is saying that. Got my point? I think that's it for today. This is most important avastha is there. There are three most important avasthas that I haven't touched up to this extent. Those avasthas may be sometimes later. In some other class, we are going out of the time bound basically. So this class only up to this extent. I will once again repeat, it is not a problem of Parashar, of course not. I will tell you one point. So let me tell you who Parashar is. So there are 18 pravartakas of astrology. You know what is a pravartaka? Reformer. So basically, how I understand it, Jyotish is an agam. Okay? All the agams. Or Jyotish is a part of Tantra. It is Kal Vidhan Tantra. The Tantra which deals about time. The nature of time, the result of time, the fructification of time, etc. Jyotish is basically known as Kal Vidhana Shastra. I will tell you a funny story. So there was a Skandora course that I was doing. And I told in that course that I personally prefer to the goddess of astrology is Jyotishmati, Devi Jyotishmati. Some people from that course who are now teachers in some institute, famous institute, have started writing above their course posters, Om this Nama. Om Jyotishmati Nama. Oh my God. See, there are very few original researchers in the world at any given point of time. Right? One Einstein, another or other. However, coming to my point. So basically, astrology is a Kala Vidhan Tantra. Tantra is a mechanism and astrology is the mechanism of how time works, the nature, quality, trait, etc. of time. And all the Tantras are told from Shiva to Parvati. It was also told from Shiva to Parvati. There is a text of those astrology books who follow the astrology taught by Shiva. There's a separate sect of those books, astrology taught by Shiva. There's a different sect. And this Vimshottari Dasha is a Dasha that is propounded by Shiva. That's why Parashara himself mentions that I am telling you the Dasha which Shiva have told. Vimshottari. That's why it is so popular. However, leave it. So basically, Shiva told this to Parvati. And sages listened to it. In Shabar Mantra, Shiva told the mantras to Parvati, Machandranath listened to it in the form of fish. This Kala Vidhana Shastra, Shiva told it to Parvati and sages listened to it. Out of those sages, you can say there were these Pravartakas. Pravartaka is basically the reformer. Jaimini produced a new system. He is into production. Parashara is a reformer. He have reformed. And what does reformation mean? That there is an astrology that is being practiced. Parashar is a person who learned complete astrology. And after learning the complete astrology, he decides that these principles I use in my practice. I use these principles in this particular way. Puts some researches over it, modifies it, and teaches it to their students. This is what pravartakas or acharyas or the guru is supposed to do. He is supposed to learn astrology from the tradition, modify it as per his practice, and teach it to their students. For example, in medical course, I have recently taught a new dasha. In some course, I will teach a new divisional chart. Many courses, I will produce new researches. So basically, in the Tajik course also, I taught you the Tajik system. And in between, I taught my principles for Tajik that I have developed. Getting my point? So that is reforming it. Taking the branch, making it better with my researches and experience, and then teaching it to the students. This is what reformers do. This is what Parashara have done. Throughout the text, Parashara have mentioned many people. When he mentions about divisional charts, he mentions, I have learned this from Brahma. He's not saying I have devised it. He said, I learned it from Brahma. It is not his research. It is Brahma's research. And in later books, so basically, in the chapter on divisional charts, he says, Drekkane Bhratrajam Sokyam, from D3, you have to see siblings. And he says it is told by Brahma. In the book, BPHS, from D3, he decides death, etc. Not siblings. What does that mean? That Brahma is telling see D3 for siblings, but others are not looking at siblings from D3. They are looking death from D3. They have reformed it their way. Are you getting my point? So Parashara is basically a reformer. He's a very great teacher. He has added his experience and made astrology better. But the problem is specifically what I have highlighted today, that you will blindly read BPHS not knowing what is told by Parashar, what is not told by Parashar, and what is added later on just to sell the book. Like Jaimini astrology part in Parashar. Parashara himself says Jaimini astrology. Why you say Jaimini astrology? Come on. So the Jaimini part in Parashara is not of Parashara's, and many things in BPHS is not of Parashara. And the problem is this amalgamation, turning apart the sanctity of the text, this adulteration have created this particular problem that we have forgot what Parashara actually proposed. So I think we'll continue this particular series and discover more of Parashara. And then the same thing we will do in this Parashara Sutras course also, which is starting from March. And I will tell you, Parashara is so important, so important, so important, that after 14th century, the traditional astrology was known by the name of Parashari astrology. It is so important that after 14th century, the traditional astrology is known by the name of Parashari astrology. But what before 14th century? Right?